Hello friends, today we will talk about clinical features of rickets. It is a disease of growing bones. Normally, bone consists of a protein matrix, that is osteoid, and a mineral phase which is composed of calcium and phosphate, mostly in the form of hydroxyapatite. Rickets is caused by unmineralized matrix at the growth plate in children only before fusion of the epiphyses. There occurs thickening of the growth plate. The clinical features comprise of failure to thrive, frontal bossing, craniotabes, rachitic rosary or Harrison's groove, enlargement of the wrist and the ankle joints leading to valgus and varus deformities. Hypocalcemic symptoms can be tetany or seizures. They can be scoliosis or kyphosis. Craniotabes is the early sign that should be looked for in early infancy, that is around 3 months of age. It occurs due to softening of the outer table of the cranial bones, and it can be detected by applying pressure at the occiput or over the parietal bones away from the suture lines. Here is a patient in whom we can appreciate prominence of the frontal bone. Frontal bossing occurs due to deposition of the excess osteoid and the non-calcified cartilage over the frontal and the parietal region. Alopecia is a feature which is seen in vitamin D dependent rickets type 2. There is delayed closure of the fontanelles. The anterior fontanelle, which usually closes between 9 to 18 months of age, remains wide open and its closure is delayed. And the posterior fontanelle, which usually closes within a few weeks after birth, may remain open. There is delayed eruption of the teeth. There are no incisors by the age of 10 months and no molar by the age of 18 months. Rachitic rosary is characterized by feeling of a bead-like structure due to thickening of the costochondral cartilage, and it is usually painless as opposed to the scurvetic rosary. Harrison's sulcus is a horizontal groove along the attachment of the diaphragm due to constant pulling of the soft ribs by the diaphragm. There can be pectus carinatum or pigeon chest, that is forward protrusion of the sternum, or there can be pectus excavatum. Here is another child in whom we can appreciate depressed ribs, protruded abdomen, curved radius and ulna. There is widening of the wrists. When an infant learns to bear weight on the arms, there occurs widening of the wrist joint. This happens due to excess of non-mineralized osteoid resulting in the growth plate widening and abnormal configuration of the metaphyses. There occurs widening of the ankle joint and bowing of the legs. This occurs when the infant learns to stand and walk due to pressure on the ankle joint. This is another patient with bowing of the legs and varus deformity. The X-ray findings consist of fraying, that is indistinct margin of the metaphyses, splaying, that is widening of the metaphyseal ends, and cupping, seen as the concavity of the metaphyses. The spinal deformities in rickets consist of kyphosis, that is exaggerated forward curvature of the spine, and scoliosis, which is sideways curvature of the spine. Patient can also present with carpopedal spasm due to hypocalcemic tetany.